Hold up. Wait a minute. It's time to...
Pew, pew, pew. Pew, pew.
She know I'm leaving it in there, right?
Y'all know that.
Money, power, respect.
What up, world? Welcome back to Three the Hard Way TV. We got the beautiful Catherine. We got the beautiful...
Mighty.
The OG, triple OG.
Right.
My aunt, dead.
That's right.
On today's show, I'm going to read off the question. And you may hear occasional noises in the background from Diana. She's intoxicated.
Yes, I am.
So just ignore those. Ignore those rants. It says, hello, my name is Jasmine. First of all, I love your show. I am dealing with a man who knows I want a serious monogamous relationship with marriage as a goal. He keeps selling me all these dreams, but his actions are not lining up with his words. They always think a nigga a lie.
Y'all know though.
I mean, but you real talk, it sound like some bullshit what she said.
I feel we are not on the same page, but every time I try to move on, he doesn't want to let me go.
So,
question one, how can I tell if he's serious and just not stringing me along? And question two, if a man is not serious about a woman, why hold on to the relationship? Control.
Nobody asked me to answer it.
Well, I got a question for this young lady. What's this young lady's name?
Her name Jasmine. Is Jasmine. Jasmine.
So, when Jasmine say he won't let her go, what does that mean? He got some bars on the gate?
I agree.
You know, I don't understand what that means.
Like, no,
he won't let me go.
It means like that at the end of the day, if they get into it and she's like, you know what, I'm done. I'm gonna leave. I'm gonna just get my things and I'm gonna go. He's like, no. Then that's when he starts with the, oh, well, you know what, baby, I do love you. I do want to be in a relationship. I do want to get married. I'm just not today, though,
right,
when
right.
our time is coming. But then when things are cool and she's like, okay, fine, I'm going to stay because obviously he wants me here. So then after that, what happens? They're cool for like a couple months, maybe a couple weeks, and then they get into it again because she's on the whole, what happened? I thought you wanted to get married.
I can see that.
You know, so he's not letting her go.
So is it that he's not letting her go or she don't want to go?
It's both.
So therefore, is she responsible for all that? So he got to be accountable because he's weak?
Drop that knowledge on him, OG.
So let me reframe the question. So he don't want her let her go because she's indecisive.
She's not indecisive. She knows what she
they
wants.
They both indecisive.
So how could she know what she want if she's telling him I'm leaving, but then she stayed? Then obviously she don't want to leave. So obviously
because you better get out of the middle.
To be honest with me, as a woman, I say I want to leave, but I want you to tell me, no, baby, don't leave, because that makes me feel better.
I like that.
So she basing her life and her self-worth on how somebody else make her feel.
I'm being one.
And that's not what life's about.
No, I make myself feel better.
Yeah, you make yourself feel better, but the whole point of finding
love for me,
is to also have them feel even more better together.
Well, when you have a companion, it's about complimenting. So if I'm complimenting you, that means I'm picking you up when you're weak at, and you picking me up when I'm weak at. But it's not about me telling you that I love you. I love a lot of things that not
good.
What you say? Because I'm pretty sure they didn't hear that.
I mean, I love a lot of things that are not good to me, but do I continue to be attached to it?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
So what I'm saying is, why be with a woman that's not good for you?
Huh?
Why be with a woman that's not good for you?
Absolutely.
That's
what So that's what he's saying. If she's with this guy and he's not in alignment with her particular goals, then she needs to reevaluate her goals.
That's right.
She's
not believing in herself because here's the thing, baby, he ain't trying to be.
And she's going against her own principles.
So let's get off into her first question after she breaks it down. She says, how can I tell if he's serious and not just stringing me along?
He's stringing you along. You hear me? It ain't serious. Because you don't value yourself. You get what I'm saying? You have no value to you. You see that weakness in you? Like, why the fuck? Like, come on. Like, the fuck? Like, girl, you ain't trapped. You like that shit just like my homegirl was saying. You love, oh, baby, don't leave. But you ain't valuing. Why should he value you? You have no value to yourself. Like, it's no value. You got no value to yourself or for another person to value you on. You are not valuing yourself. It's crazy. I don't see how somebody can prevent you from living your best life and being great. So, life's too fucking short. Like,
I think what the young lady Jasmine needs to evaluate is not as so much as how could she know if he's screening her along. What is it that you know about yourself? Why is he trying to figure him out instead of trying to learn who you are?
It's making it so bad. Like, that shit made that. And there's nothing wrong with being weak. That means you was raised by somebody that was weak. That's not.
Well, we all got weaknesses, right? We all got weaknesses.
We do, but this right here. Like, I'm going to tell you something just like Sam was saying.
Just because you love someone, Jasmine, doesn't mean that's the right person for you.
I love salt, pork. You hear me? This will tear down a whole pack of bacon. Oh my God, I love it. But I know I can't, I don't even bite that shit. Like, you can't love something that's gonna kill you. Like, love you more than shit.
Okay, who doesn't want to be appreciated? Man, woman, child, what?
He ain't the one appreciate you, let him go. Let him go! And you need to, like, sweetheart, you sitting there reaching. Maybe your standards are a little too high. Maybe you're going after that 10. You need to be looking more at the 2s and the 3s.
You're a beautiful woman. At some point, you're gonna make
sure. Nobody says she ain't beautiful, but girl,
I'm talking about beautiful inside out. At some point, you're gonna make something happen. Right. At the same time, you don't need no affirmation from the outside.
I'm sorry, Gary.
You gotta look at terms.
Excuse me. If you want to be on Scott, you'll be okay.
That's what you just said. You just said if he don't love you, he never gonna love you.
The law. I said she don't love herself.
Then
she can't respect
others'
love.
Right. How's she gonna respect that?
Because she allowed someone to string her along. Game recognized game.
But what I'm saying is, Jasmine is only going off the words that she hears. What? If you niggas stop lying, then people won't believe what you're saying.
That's what's wrong.
So you telling me that just because someone says something?
No, I'm not telling you. I'm speaking for Jasmine, okay? Because Diane don't believe shit.
Right. But just because someone says something out that mouth, it means it's true.
Hell no, not to be
well,
with
if she choose to go off everything someone said out their mouth, then she has to be learned.
Some people, look, as a child in the society we live in, women, young girls are raised, they play with baby dolls, they play with strollers, they pretend to get married. All of this stuff is instilled in the woman from birth. So she's not doing anything but acting out the things that went on through her childhood.
Absolutely.
And she raised up and she think that that's what happened now.
Listen to this. Because, you know, I play basketball, football, all that shit, but I had doubts. You get what I'm saying? Like, I'm deadly girly shit as well. And guess what? I'm not a weak bitch. And nobody's gonna string me the fuck along. Now, I know that I'd rather fucking be alone. I'd rather be fucking alone than to have a motherfucking thing that but they own me that they can do. No, you have to value yourself. I mean, no value. If she was holding
she won't
believe that shit. Like, this girl probably been with this nigga for about 5 years.
I mean, you only as strong as your weakest link.
What difference do it make how long she's been with me? I think that the young lady is looking for validation, she's looking for love.
Right.
There may be a lot of different factors that's going on in her life. I don't think that she's weak. I think that, you know, she just got to learn from experience.
Well, yeah, she got to learn from experience, but we don't know how old she is. We don't know how old she is. We don't know. Because this situation, you got to, listen, his behavior so far is telling me that he ain't on that with you.
How do we know that's his behavior? And it's just not an interpretation.
Because see what I'm going off of that email. That's all I have to go off. I can't speculate, but from that email, she had a number of questions for us.
Right.
Sweetheart, if you gotta ask us that shit and you ain't seeing it yourself, then get out. It is life's too short.
She's not seeing it herself, that's why you
She, so somebody, I told you, you're going after 10. Knowledge. Get you like a 2 or 1, if you will. You get what I'm saying?
A 1.
Like, or a 2 or 1. You get what I'm saying?
A 1, that motherfucker might have a leg shorter than another one.
That type of emotional, if she needs that emotional thing, maybe if she can't get without that, it's a learning experience. Get you somebody a little bit quick shooting so I get somebody low and
no,
see how
no,
it works
no,
out.
No, no, no. Someone that's low can run over you just like if someone is
I
high.
Mean, she's exactly. Going after 10. Look like she is. It sounds like he's a 10.
Know who she is. Unless Jazz begin to identify who she is and she quit looking for validation from these guys, I right. Love you. You satchel. Damn you beautiful. Damn you boy. So once you shut that down and identify who you truly is, then when this guy words come out, if it's not in line with your goals, then that's what you look at. So don't talk about his words not in line with what he like, do. But if his goal or his words is in line with your goals. Right. So there's no hostage situation now unless you choose to be a hostage.
Okay. Okay, so this is the second part of it. She says, if a man is not serious about a woman, why hold on to the relationship? And you were speaking on this a little bit earlier in what you were saying. If a man is not serious about a woman, why hold on to the relationship? Why do you feel like men do that?
I feel like over control. Like, it's either over control or just, you know, at the moment they're not ready. It could be they're scared. You know what I'm saying? Like, they're not at the same level that she's at.
No, and I think
do you think it could possibly be that she's looking for,
like, it all depends on how long they've been together. Because if they've only been together for 6 months. How the hell is she expecting
like,
him to be ready
bitch?
To marry already?
No,
if they've been dating
no,
for like
no,
5 years,
no,
you know what I'm saying?
No,
and at the
no,
end
no,
end
no,
she,
no.
Some women look for a man to kind of like guide them through life, you know? Maybe.
What
a
woman.
Let me. Oh no, so if you move out, you'll be on this couch. So
ooh, I'm sorry.
Look, everybody who get in relationship because they looking for a benefit. Nothing else.
Okay.
If I'm with a woman. And she let me come in at 3-4 o'clock in the morning. That's why I'm with her. If I've got a woman who want me to come in at 9 o'clock and I want to come in 3 or 4 in the morning, I'm going to fuck with the woman who let me come in 3 or 4 in the morning.
Okay.
So, obviously, this guy got something that Jasmine wants, and Jasmine got to figure out what that is, and that's why she tolerating whatever he doing. Because
he got something that she wants.
Even if she want a motherfucker to say, I love you, and that's why she trapped and encaged and mentally enslaved to this guy.
Hey, ladies, my uncle's single and putting the information below.
If you let him come in at 3.
And you know, I used to
if they let you come in at 3 though, right?
Exactly.
If you available,
I'm available. Jab, you got to do a cost benefits analysis. What is it about this guy that you really like, right? Just because you like someone don't mean that he's the best person for you, right?
Exactly.
You can like anything in the world. A person can say anything out their mouth, but it really comes down to how you truly appreciate it yourself.
That's
right?
Awesome young girl.
So he may not be a bad guy, but his goals is not in alignment with yours. So if you choose to listen to these particular words, then you got to ask yourself, is that something you like to hear? Baby, I love you. I want to be with you. You gorgeous. You the sexiest thing I ever had, girl. I ain't never had no pussy like this.
Like, really?
You like
me?
You
like me? So well.
And if that's what turns you on, then you're going to allow him to continue.
Hey, no.
You
know, I actually, it's everybody that has something that you would consider the best out of what you had.
Exactly.
So that couldn't be totally
like, you know,
untrue. That couldn't be totally false. Cause you can get that shit and you be like, shit, this is the best I've had. For now.
Right now.
Up until this point.
At the end of the day, Jack, it's not what a person say out of their mouth. You can't focus on what a person can make their mouth say anything.
Yes. Amen.
You have to focus on the behavior. If a person's behavior is not in alignment with your goals, then what a person says out their mouth really don't matter.
Right.
So you can't all this pillow talk and all this old nonsense.
That's too hard.
This inflatable ego that you want people to just elevates you and you want to feel like you're the best, then the next thing
you're not doing
like
nothing
shit,
right? You're not doing nothing to elevate yourself.
Why are you hurting me? I love you. I did it out there for you.
Like, why can't I lay on my chest right now? Bitch, I'm tired.
Find yourself. If you find yourself, invest in yourself, spend some time with yourself.
You heard that.
Get to know who you truly are. And once you find who you are, if you develop some principles about yourself.
We need to have like a therapy portion of Three the Hard Way TV. So, ladies, she's taking
the game
questions.
Up, Jazz, and you want to be all right.
Audience, I'm most definitely.
Ask Derek. That's gonna be the next
set. Hey, audience, most definitely dragging my uncle back. You know what I'm saying? He came in, and you know what I'm saying. Hey,
I love everyone who let me have threesomes. Let me drive that car and all that shit. And I love you too. And I'm coming home 3-4 days later. I love you. You the best woman I ever had. My baby, beautiful. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, on that note,
we out.
we got the beautiful Catherine. We got the beautiful
Marty.
I don't want to fuck it up. And my OG Uncle Dad. Y'all send those.
Dropping them.
Y'all send those questions in, man. We out. Three the Hard Way TV.
It's your boy Real Hill from Three the Hard Way TV. Go like our fan page on Facebook. Also subscribe to the YouTube. Don't forget to like and share this video. Comment under the link. It's your boy Real.
Shout out to all our fans that love us. We love you too. And shout out to my motherfucking haters.
Y'all,
I love you motherfuckers, okay?
And I know y'all see the ladies looking good in them Three the Highway TV shirts.
The Highway TV.
Yeah. The big asses.
Y'all hit that subscribe button for y'all chance to win official Three the Hard Way TV gear. I don't know if y'all gonna be able to make those shirts look as good as the ladies got them looking.
Shout out to the stylist.
All day, money, power, respect, Three the Hard Way.